Story citywide curfew is in effect until 5 o'clock in the morning. Rival gangs here in the city say that they have reached a truce. They are working together, not to fight the police, but to fight for justice for Freddie Gray. I spoke with some of them today. Look at this. So all of you are with someone. They say that they're the Crips out here, the Bloods are out here, the Black Guerrilla families out here. You won't tell me your affiliation.
Right. We're not really press to tell you guys our affiliation. We just press to put out the exposure right that now. We together. That's all we're trying to do. We together. We live in a police state where every day we come out, we're being harassed by the police, man. They checking out private areas and public areas. It's just out of hand, man. Right.
Even when you are not doing anything, are you doing something for them to check you?
Anybody, oh, this, I'm saying this.
Stereotypes, man. Stereotypes.
That's why it's not all about the colors right now, for right. real. It's all about the Black man.
Colors right. meaning?
Meaning the gangs and different organizations. Right. Yeah, a lot of the people may belong to certain things, but that don't mean nothing because we all united right now. It's a bigger systematic problem that we got to deal with. Yeah. That's why it's 300-500 people out here from the community right now today.
When you see the stuff that happened with the looting and the fires or whatever, is that gang related? Who is that?
No, that's not gang related. We have nothing to do with that. We're the ones out here that's trying to bring peace and stop everything.
When you see pictures of like what happened last night, the burning and stuff on television, what do y'all think?
It makes us look bad, man, because it's not the cause.
Disgrace.
At the end of the day, what they show on the news and what they show to the media, they show them what they want to see. They don't actually let them see what's really going on between us.
So what's really going on?
Unity. The unity between all of these rivals that wouldn't even be together standing right here right now.
The kids were the ones who acted out in that manner. But right now, the children are going off because they have no recreational parks.
And they angry. You can't keep on poking somebody in the back and think they're not going to turn around and swing. Like, we at our boiling point. And we survivors in Baltimore because that's what they made us by the way that they treated us.
When was the last time, has there ever been a truce like this called between all the colors?
Never. Never in Baltimore.
So it was said that all of the people who, it all started because gang members said, we're gonna riot, we're gonna loot, we're gonna.
That was said by social media, that was said by the commission.
You think that was social media doing it?
Yeah. And the police. Who else they gonna blame it on when they can't control it themselves?
They don't want us.
Well, RSA, what is we gonna get out of looting? We ain't worried about no looting because we make money. You feel me? Like, whereas though, yeah, we make money to get whatever we want. So, like, whereas though, we gonna look good. We ain't gonna go loot no store. That's phony. Like, whereas though, yeah, like, why destroy the community where I lived at my whole life? You hear me?
We not out here trying to say that we're saints, that we all just the most innocent people in the world. We trying to say that we're making effective changes in our community, or at least trying. Unified. It started with Freddie Gray, now we're gonna take it to the next level. And we need everybody's support. It's not just Baltimore, this is affecting the whole country right now.
I want to tell our viewers, first thank them for that. We're going to speak to these guys in just a minute. We're awaiting a press conference from Baltimore Police. We're going to bring that to you just as soon as that press conference begins. Waiting that press conference, we'll bring it in. I want to bring the Reverend Lennox Shearwood. Rev Lennox Shearwood, the founder of Hip Hop Caucus, Vote or Die. He's in here in Baltimore with me. And also Carmichael Kennedy, Stokey Kennedy, and he joins us as well, an anti-violence activist. We were out in that park today. You helped me gather those members of different colors or gangs. What is it? How significant is that?
Well, it's very instrumental into what we do as a community and leaders of our own environment, because I think it was paramount for us to come out today, you know, and unify in a positive notion to let these kids know we can be their voice in a very positive manner.
How many people did you have out in that park today? I saw a couple hundred people.
Like a thousand people.
You wanted them to have something productive to do while they weren't in school.
Exactly. Well, we really wanted to be the voice for the kids. And like I said earlier, my job and my objective was from certain phone calls from friends and certain factions to get the kids together, to get them off the street, and explain to them there's a better way to express themselves.
Yeah. We can give credit to the leaders today of the city. Definitely. We can give credit to the police departments. Yesterday was a different story, but we also have to give credit to members of the community and community leaders, Rev.
We do, and I think that's why I want to give them the most credit. I think they're doing a wonderful job. I think that one thing about Baltimore, our activists like Stokey and others like that have been coming up big, organizing the gangs to be a part of the solution. I think most importantly, the young folks are simply saying that they want to be heard. There's the anger, there's the frustration, and they are tired of not being a part of the table. They're saying, listen, we want to be part of the solution, and we want to be part of the solution now. And they're angry, and they're frustrated. So I'm so happy that leaders are coming together, new leaders are coming together to say that we need to right this wrong and come to justice, not only for Freddie Gray, but for the all things that have been happening in Baltimore for many, many years now.
Yeah. You know, I thought it was interesting because they talked about the disconnect with not only between police, right, and the community, but the disconnect between the world, how the world is viewing Baltimore. What we're reading on social media isn't necessarily the case. Surely there's violence. We saw people looting. We see all of that. But people should not be afraid to go into the communities. They wanted me. They welcomed me when I got there. Members of the gang brought me food and said, hey, we want you to come here because we're trying to get it together.
I mean, that's a myth. I mean, I understand that you have atrocities all over the country, all over the nation, especially when you deal with young violence. But last night, which we strongly condemn, as the Rev said, was an expression. And it was the way the young kids could voice themselves. And Baltimore's a beautiful place. I've been here my entire life. I don't like a lot of policies, and I know there's a lot of kids without fathers based on the mandatory minimum prison guidelines and things of that nature, but we do what we can do with what we have.
And there are lots of people who are working to make it better.
Exactly.
There were some people who were upset by the president's comment. Some people who said, listen, we're working. You know, the president said there were thugs who were causing the trouble last night, and they didn't like some of the terms, but people here are working, both white and black, to help the communities.
Yeah, we had a real cohesive effort today with white and black people who came together to bring about a positive peace, you know, solution, because we knew that the media only shows what they can show. I mean, I understand they're not in the communities all the time, so when they have an opportunity to show negativity, they're going to show that. But today, as you witnessed, we had 1,000 people without police presence. There was no violence, no melee. There was any type of problematic situations that, you know, would cause them to come. So, you know, I'm proud to say that we did that, and hopefully tomorrow we can move forward with the narrative of continuing to be peace and positive and bring about a positive solution. And hopefully we can seek justice not only for Freddie Gray, but for all the young guys that have been, you know, frustrated and angered over the years.
And hopefully the conversation will get back to what needs to be. Thank you. I didn't recognize you. Clean up very well.
Yeah, I was working, man.
Nice to meet
man.
You, and you're like, you met me earlier.
Thank
you,
man.
No, thank you so much.
I appreciate it.
We will keep fighting.
Yeah, thank you very much. We'll have you back on. All right, keep us updated.
Definitely.
I'm going to bring in now CNN's Mark Lamont Hill, a political commentator, also Van Jones with us, a CNN political contributor here as well. And as we await this press conference, guys, we want to talk to you. You know, look, last night, Van, I know you, I was, you were, I don't know if Mark was as hard on the leadership, but we wanted answers, and you know what? They stepped up.
Absolutely. I think everybody had tough questions. But, you know, they went from a case study in leadership reversal. You had a D-minus yesterday, probably by their own assessment privately, and you go from that to an A-plus. The big danger today was that you're so humiliated by what happened yesterday that you overreact today. Instead, you saw, I mean, really a casebook study of how they set expectations, they partnered with community. It's really a triumph of people power, community power, as much as anything else. A massive celebration today. Hope went viral today. Peace went viral today. Cooperation went viral today, whereas violence went viral last night. And so I think you've got to give, if you're going to criticize the mayor for yesterday, you've got to give the mayor and police a lot of credit for today.